Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
Welcome to Temple Emmanuel. Wonderful to see all of you here as we celebrate Shabbat and as we celebrate Max becoming a bar mitzvah, wearing a talit for the first time. A very, very exciting moment and very exciting morning for all of us. My name is Rabbi Farbman, and this is Susan Pinsky-Blix, who is our cantorial soloist this morning. We are very excited to sing with you, to pray with you, and to celebrate this special moment. A few words of introduction. First, the prayer book that you hold in your hands, hopefully, is called Mishkan Tefillah. It's designed a little differently from perhaps other books that you've used in the past, in that most of the traditional service can be found on the right-hand side in the even-numbered pages, and the left page, with few exceptions, contains lots of alternative readings, poetry, sometimes commentary. So if you need to let your mind wander a little bit, you can check out the right page or the left. But if we didn't announce the page and you finished reading whatever it is that's on the right-hand side, just turn the page over. If you're slightly lost, check out what your neighbors are doing. If everybody's lost, then we'll get there at some point, I'm sure. The other thing that to mention is we are a very singing congregation, so if you know the melodies, please join in. If you don't know the melodies that we're singing, please count to five and join in. That's pretty much the way it works at Temple Emmanuel. Last but not least, would you please reach out into your pockets, your right, your left, whichever you carry your communication device in, and please shut it off. And be in the moment. So for the next hour and a half, you won't need the device to communicate with the Eternal. We have a direct line here. You don't need minutes or internet or anything like that. Everybody else hopefully can wait. Our service is being live streamed, so it will be. I know that there are some family members who are joining from all across the country, and maybe even further beyond. And of course, there will be the live stream on YouTube will also be accessible at a later time. So just be in the moment, enjoy, and we look forward to celebrating Shabbat together. Page 74. Blessed are you, Adonai, our God, page 77, sovereign of the universe. With divine wisdom you have made our bodies, combining veins, arteries, and vital organs into a finely balanced network. Wondrous maker and sustainer of life, were one of them to fail, how well we are aware, we would lack the strength to stand before you. Blessed are you, Adonai, source of our health and strength, Baruch Ata Adonai, Rofe Chol Basar, Umafli Lasot. Page 78.
Thank you.
Baruch Ata Adonai, Asher Beyado Nefesh Kol Chai, Veruach Kol Besar Ish. Praise thy Adonai, in whose hand is every living soul and the breath of humankind. We continue now with morning blessings on page 80, as I invite Max to join us on the plan. Baruch Ata Adonai, Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, who has given the mind the ability to distinguish day from night.
Amen. Baruch Ata Adonai, Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, who opens the eyes of the blind.
Amen. Baruch Ata Adonai, Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, who frees the captive.
Amen. Baruch Ata Adonai, Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, who lifts up the fallen.
Amen. Baruch Ata Adonai, Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, who stretches the earth over the waters.
Amen. Baruch Ata Adonai, Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, who strengthens our steps.
Amen. Baruch Ata Adonai, Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, who clothes the naked.
Amen. Baruch Ata Adonai, Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, who gives strength to the weary.
Amen. Baruch Ata Adonai, Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, who removes sleep from the eyes, slumber from the eyelids.
Amen. Baruch Ata Adonai, Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, who has made me in the image of God.
Amen. Baruch Ata Adonai, Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, who has made me free.
Amen. Baruch Ata Adonai, Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, who has made me a Jew.
Amen. Baruch Ata Adonai, Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, who girds Israel with strength.
Amen. Baruch Ata Adonai, Melech HaOlam, who crowns Israel with splendor.
Amen.
Baruch Ata Adonai, Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, Asher Kadishanu Mitzvotav, Letzivanu La'asot B'Divrei Torah. O Adonai, our God, let the words of the Torah be sweet in our mouths, and let the mouths of your people, Israel, so that we, our descendants, and the descendants of your people, Israel, may know you. By studying your Torah for its sake, blessed are you, Adonai, who reaches Torah to your people Israel.
Amen. Baruch Ata Adonai, Hamelamed Torah Le'amo Yisrael.
These are things that are limitless, of which a person enjoys the fruit of the world. While the principle remains in the world to come, they are honoring one's father and mother, engaging in deeds of compassion, arriving early for study, morning and evening, dealing graciously with guests, visiting the sick and providing for the wedding couple, accompanying the dead for burial, being devoted in prayer, and making peace among people. But the study of Torah encompasses them all. Please turn to page 96.
Merlin, she's back.
page 100. Praised are you, Adonai our God, sovereign of the universe, creator of light and darkness, who makes peace and fashions all things. In mercy, you illumine the world and those who live upon it. In your goodness, you daily renew creation. How numerous are your words, Adonai. In wisdom, you form them all, filling the earth with your creations. Be praised, Adonai our God, for the excellent work of your hands, in the light, and for the lights you created. May they glorify you. Shine a new light upon Zion, that we all may swiftly merit in its radiance. Praised are you, Adonai, creator of all heavenly lights. Baruch atah Adonai, Yatzor Hamot. How deeply you have loved us, Adonai, our God, gracing us with surpassing compassion. On account of our forebears, for whose trust led you to teach them the laws of life, be gracious to us, teaching us as well. O merciful one, have mercy on us by making us able to understand and discern, to heed, learn, and teach, and lovingly to observe, perform, and fulfill all that is in your Torah.
Rise for the Shema. Tam levanecha, ve divartam abam.
Ushiftecha habaveitecha, uvelechecha habaderech, uveshovecha halekumecha, ushartam leot al yadecha, vehayu letotafot beinecha, uchtavtam al mezuzot beitecha,
please join me in reading responsively in the middle of page 121. The eternal truth is that you alone are God, and there is none else.
May the righteous of all nations rejoice in your love and exult in your justice.
Let them beat their swords into plowshares, and let their spears into pruning hooks.
Let nation not lift up sword against nation, nor learn war anymore.
You shall not hate your brother or your sister in your heart.
The stranger that sojourns with you shall be accepted as your equal, for you were strangers in the land of Egypt.
Why do you crush my people and oppress the poor, asked God?
We know that the Eternal One defends the poor and upholds the rights of the needy.
Praise to God, Most High.
Blessed is God and deserving of blessing.
We are on page 122. Israel, uvdechnu mecha, Yehuda ve Israel, Goaleinu Adonai Tzvaot Shemo, Kedosh Israel, Baruch Atah Adonai. Ga'al Israel. We continue now with Amidah on page 124. Would you please rise if you're able? Adonai
lefatai tiftachu fi agite hilatecha. Adonai, open my lips that my mouth may declare your praise. Yainai nai, anananai, yananai nai, yanananai, yananai. Ata Adonai Eloheinu Velohe Avoteinu Veimoteinu Elohe Abraham Elohe Yitzchak Velohe Yaakov Elohe Sarah Elohe Rivka Elohe Rachel Velohe Leah Ha'el Agadol Agibor Ve'anora El Elyon Gomel Chasadim Tovim Vekone Akol Vezocher Chasdei Avot Veimaot Umidi Geula Levnevnehem Lema'an Shimo Ve'ahava Melech Ozer Umoshia Umagen Baruch Ata Adonai Magen Avraham Bezrat Sarah Ata Gibor Leolam Adonai Mechayeh Kol Atarav Lehoshia Morid Hatal Mechalkel Chaim Becheset Mechayeh Kol Berachamim Rabim Somech noflim verofe cholim umatir asurim umekayem emunato lishenei afar michamocha ba'al gevurot umidoh melach melech meimit umechaye umatzmiach yeshua V'nemanata l'chayot ha'akol Baruch ata Adonai Mechaye ha'akol Nekadesh et shimcha ba'olam Keshem shemakdishim oto b'shmei marok Kakatuv al yad nevi'echa Vekaraze alze veamar Kadosh, kadosh, kadosh Adonai Tzevaot Meloch kol haaretz Kevodo Adir, adireinu Adonai Adoneinu ma'adir shimcha bechol ha'aretz Baruch kevod Adonai mimkomo Echadu Eloheinu Hu avinu hu malkeinu Hu moshienu vehu yashmienu Berachamav le'enei kol chai Ani Adonai Eloheichem Imloch Adonai le'olam Elohaik Tzion Ledor Adoram Leluyam Ledor vador nagid God lecha ולנצח נצחים קדושתך נקדיש ושבחך אלוהינו מפינו לא ימוש לעולם ועד ברוך אתה אדוני האל הקדוש.
Please be seated. We continue now in the middle of page 132.
Veishamru bene Israel et ha-shabbat lasot et ha-shabbat ledorot ha-meritola Veishamru bene Israel et ha-shabbat lasot et ha-shabbat ledorot ha-meritola Bein Yudim b'nei Yisrael, b'nei Yisrael, odi le'olam. Veishamru b'nei Yisrael et ha-shabbat, lasot et ha-shabbat ledorotam berit olam. Ki sheshet yamim Asa Adonai, et ha-shamayim ve-et ha-aretz ve-shamru b'nei Yisrael et ha-shabbat, lasot et ha-shabbat ledorotam berit olam. Uvayom ha-shvi'i shabbat v'yinavash. Shabbat v'yinavash, Shabbat v'yinavash. Veishamru b'nei Yisrael et ha-shabbat, lasot et ha-shabbat ledorotam berit olam.
Our God and God of our ancestors, be pleased with our rest. Sanctify us with your mitzvot, and grant us a share in your Torah. Sanctify us with your goodness, and gladden us with your salvation. Purify our hearts to serve you in truth, in your gracious love. Adonai, our God, grant us your holy Shabbat as heritage. May Israel, who sanctifies your name, rest on Shabbat. Blessed are you, Adonai, who sanctifies Shabbat. Baruch atah Adonai, mikadesh ha-Shabbat.
Ritzei Adonai Eloheinu, B'amcha Yisrael, U'tefilatam, B'ahava tikabel. Utehil ratzon tamid, utehil ratzon tamid, avodah Yisrael amecha, baruch atah Adonai, hamachazir shechinato. Shechinato letzion, ha-machazir shechinato, shechinato letzion.
We acknowledge with thanks that you are Adonai, our God and God of our ancestors. Forever you are the rock of our lives, and we shield our salvations in every generation. Let us thank you and praise you for our lives which are in your hands. For our souls which are in your care, for your miracles that we experience every day, and for your wondrous deeds and favors at every time of day, evening, morning, and noon. O good one, who mercifies never ends. O compassionate one, whose kindness never fails, we forever put our hopes in you. For all these things, O Sovereign, let your name be forever praised and blessed. O God, our Redeemer and Helper, let all life affirm you in praise, your name in truth. Blessed are you, Adonai, your name is goodness, and you are truly worthy of thanksgiving. Baruch atah Adonai, ha-tov, Shimcha ucha na'e lachodam.
page 140. Sim Shalom Tova Uvracha. Sim Shalom Tova Uvracha. Sim Shalom Tova Uvracha. En vachesed verachamim. En vachesed verachamim. Rachamim. Sim shalom. Aleinu ve'al kol Israel. Aleinu ve'al kol Israel. Amecha. Sim Baruch Ata Adonai Hamevarech Et Amo Israel Vashalom. We continue our service by leaving a few moments of silence at the end of Amidah. No matter how wonderful our prayer book is, with both the right and the left hand side, there are always things that perhaps did not find their way onto the pages of the prayer book, but that we carry in our hearts. So we'll leave a few moments of silence for our private personal prayers to be offered at this time. Bottom of page 142. Prayer for peace. Ose shalom v'him roma uya se shalom. Shalom, Uyase Shalom Aleinu.
עושה שלום במרומם. הוא יעשה שלום, הוא יעשה שלום עלינו, יעשה שלום עלינו.
At this point in our service, we are arriving at this very exciting moment as we proceed with the Torah service. We'll be turning to page 244. Things will start moving around at a slightly different pace. We'll start calling different names for all of the mitzvot, for opening the ark, undressing the Torah, and so on and so forth. And of course, we are almost at the moment when Max is going to chant from the Torah, which is very exciting. And so with that, I'm turning to Susan. Would you please rise?
We'd like to call up Max's sister Amanda and her husband Eric to help us open the ark, and also Aunt Holly Kampler can join the processional to undress the Torah.
So,
Ein kamocha v'Elohim Adonai v'ein k'ma'asecha malchutecha malchut kol olamim. וממשלתך בכל דור ודור. אדוני מלך, אדוני מלך, אדוני ימלוך לעולם ועד, אדוני עוז לעמו ייתן. Adonai yevarech et amo v'shalom. Ahava rachamim eitiva v'rtzon ha'etzion tivnei chomot Yerushalayim tivnei chomot Yerushalayim ki vecha levad batachnu melech el ram v'nisa Adon olamim, ki mitzion tetze Torah, ki mitzion tetze Torah, udevar Adonai, Yerushalayim. Baruch Shenatan Torah Torah Baruch Shenatan Torah Torah Le'amo Israel Digdushato Shema Israel Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad, Echad Eloheinu, Gadol Adoneinu, Kadosh Shemo, Gadalul Adonai Iti, Unerom ema shemo yagdav Lecha Adonai hagedula vehagevura Vehatiferet vehanetzach vehahod Ki chol bashamayim uvarez Ki chol bashamayim uvarez Lecha Adonai ha-mamlacha ve-amit-naseh lechol rosh. Romemu Adonai Eloheinu
veishtachavu lehar kodshom romemu. Come with me. Eloheinu veishtachavu lehar kodshoki ki kadosh Adonai Eloheinu romemu. Ki kadosh Adonai Eloheinu romemu. Hatia. All right.
My Torah portion, Bachar.
Slowly. Stand over here. Stand over here. Take it.
My Torah portion, Bachar B'Kulatai, covers various topics, beginning with God talking to Moses on Mount Sinai, giving instructions to Israelites. One of the instructions is that the land should have a Sabbath year where no crops are grown, but any naturally growing food can be consumed by the farmer and their family. The Jubilee year, which occurs every 50 years after seven cycles of 7 years, is also discussed, where debts and other things can be forgiven or returned. The portion also talks about how the pricing of land should be based on the number of years remaining until the next Jubilee. Additionally, the portion outlines how Israelites will survive during the seventh year when crops cannot be grown, saying the land will produce enough food for the sixth year to last 3 years. If one sells their land but cannot afford to buy it back, then during the Jubilee, the land should be returned to its original owner. The portion also brings up that houses in protected cities can be brought back within a year, but after that, the opportunity is lost. But in rural areas, the owner always has the rights to buy back the house, even if the number of years have passed. God promises rewards for trusting him and following his ways, such as rain, peace, children, and a happy life in God's land with God's presence. Disobedience, on the other hand, will result in domination by enemies, wild animals roaming the land, and constant disappointment. Above all, we must note that the land is God's, and it is only moral that we follow his rules. As I chant my verses, I invite you to consider the rules that ensure fairness in our society today.
We'll be chanting from Parashat Bahar Bechukotai, which can be found on page 531 in the Chumash, Leviticus 25, and he'll be starting with verse 1, 531. Ya'amod Abraham Eliezer ben Pesach la'aliyah rishona l'kriyat Torah. For our first aliyah to the Torah, we call up Max's great uncle Larry, our last family member to have survived the Holocaust.
Baruch Adonai Amvarach Leolam Vaed.
Baruch Adonai Amvarach Leolam Vaed. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam. Asher bachar banu mikol ha'amim benatan lanu et torato baruch ata Adonai noten ha'torah.
Amen.
V'yedaber Adonai el Moshe Behar Sinai Lemor, Daber El Bene Israel, Vamarta Alechem, Ki Tavu El Haaretz, Asher Anihi Noten Lachem, Vishavatem, Haaretz Shabbat Adonai, Shehe Shanihim Tizra Sadecha, Vashe Shanihim Tizmor Harmecha, Vesafta et Tevuata.
Baruch Atah Adonai, Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Asher natan lanu Torat emet b'chayei olam nata b'tochenu baruch ata Adonai notein haTorah.
Amen. You can come onto this side. You can shake your hand. You can shake his hand.
Ya'amdu Benyamin Yosef ben Shmuel Ze'ev Zacharia Yisrael ben Shmuel Ze'ev L'Aliyah Shniya L'Kriyat Torah. For our second Aliyah, we call up Max's brothers, Benjamin and Zachary.
Baruch Adonai Hamborach Leolam Vaed.
Baruch Adonai Hamborach Leolam Vaed. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Bahar Banu Mikol Ha'amim Venatan Lanu Et Torato. Baruch Ata Adonai Notem HaTorah.
Amen. All right, guys, one of you hold on to this.
Ugashana Hashavi Shabbat Shabbaton Yela Aretz Shabbat La Adonai Sadechalotis Raha Vacharmechalotis Mohor Et Sefiheka Ketzirecha Lo Tivsor Vet Inevi Nazirecha Lo Tivsor Shanat Shabbaton Yela Aretz Vachayata Ha Shabbat Ha Aretz Lachem Leoclaha Lecha uavdecha, v'la amatecha, v'liski recha, v'toshavecha, hagarim imach. V'lifim techa, v'lechaya, asher ba'artzecha, tia kol tevuataha lecho.
Go ahead.
Baruch ata Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, asher natan lanu torat emet, V'chaye olam natan v'tochenu, Baruch ata Adonai, notein haTorah.
Amen. You can give him a hug or something. I don't know. Okay. Come this way.
Yamut Shmuel Zev ben David, L'Aliyah Shlishit L'Kriyat haTorah. For our third Aliyah, we call up Max's parents, Steve.
Baruch Adonai Hamborach Leolam Vaed.
Baruch Adonai Hamborach Leolam Vaed. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Olam Asher Bachar Banu Mikol Hamim V'natan Lanu Et Torato. Baruch Ata Adonai Notein HaTorah.
Amen.
V'sefarta Lecha Sheva Shabbatot Shanihim, Sheva Shanihim, Sheva Pe'am. Wait. Pe'amim. Behayu Lecha, Yeme Sheva Shabbatot Hashanihim, Tesha, Barbaim Shana. Behavarta ha shofar shua Bakodesh Hashavihi Beasor Bakodesh Beyom Hakipurihim Tashviru shofar Beko Artsechem Behirashtem Et Shadat Hachamishim Shadat Ukratem Derohor Baaretz Lohel Yosavecha Yoveli Tiah Lachem Mishavetem Ish El Akuzato Veish El Mishpakto Teshuvu Yoveli Shadat Hachamishim Shadat Tiah Lachem Lo Tizruhu Velo Tivzeru Et Sefihecha Velo Tivzeruhu Et Nezirecha Ki Yovel Hi Kodesh Tieh Lachem Min Hasadeh Tocheluhu Et Tevuata.
Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Olam Asher Natan Lanu Torat Emet V'chaye Olam Nata B'tochenu Baruch Ata Adonai Notein HaTorah.
Amen. You can give him a hug.
Baruch Adonai Havarah.
Baruch Adonai Havarah Leolam Va'ed.
Baruch Adonai Havarah Leolam Va'ed. Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam. Asher Bachar Banu Mikol Hamim. V'natal Lanu Et Torato. Baruch Atah Adonai Notein HaTorah.
Amen.
Bishnat Hayovel Hazot. Teshuvu ish el achiv, v'chi timkaru mivkar la'amitecha o kano miad amitecha al tonuhu ish et achiv, v'misvahar shanihim achar hayovel haz tikne meod amitecha v'misvahar shane tevuot imkor lah. Ufi rov hashanim tarve miknato ufi meot hashanim tamihit miknato miknato ki misfahar tevuot hu hu mocher lah. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Natan Lanu Torat Emet V'Chayei Olam Ata B'Tochenu. Baruch atah Adonai Noten
HaTorah. Amen. Now you get to go and have a seat. And you get to breathe out for a second.
Just a second.
Okay, how are you doing?
I'm scared.
Okay, all right, good, good. Okay, so teach us.
I've learned many things from my Torah portion.
Remember, slow down so they can hear your teaching. Good. Okay.
I have learned many things from my Torah portion.
Don't go quiet. Go slow. This is the. I feel like we need to build in some kind of a lever here. So
sorry, it's
loud
my first time.
But slow. But.
I have learned many things from my Torah portion. The land is God's, and we should respect it as such. The 11th century commentator, Rashi, who lived in France, believed that letting the land rest could have the same benefits as humans when we get rest. In the 12th century, Ramban suggested that this Torah portion is there to help people to become better humans all around through listed activities such as donating food to the poor, freeing slaves, and forgiving any debts or loans one may owe. The 20th century commentator, Nahama Lebowitz, taught that it is a way to fairly distribute wealth amongst the nation so that there wouldn't just be a handful of rich and powerful people while the others suffer in poverty. She suggested that the land should be returned to its original owners during the Jubilee as a way of bringing justice and empathy. I believe that Rashi has a point, as Rashi basically says, God created the land, and God created us, so following his rules will have benefits for us all. But my personal understanding is that the Torah portion shows us that being kind and forgetful shows us the godly way, as we are told to forgive people of their loans or to rightfully return to them what was theirs, and that when we follow God's rules like that, he will show us the best way, hence the Sabbath, where God informed us that, in fact, following his ways again led us to prosper success and farms in our lives. Underlying, God will show us success, but it would be under his rules.
Okay. Very good. Okay, so breathe. Breathe. I want to, before we, with the Torah scroll out, we say the words of Misha Berach. You can find it on page 253. At this point in the service, as we pray for health, we mention Brianna Lapiner, Sherry Ginger, Neil Collinger, David Thompson, Nicolina Nana, Jody, and Tina Thompson. If you have other names you'd like to add to the prayer for healing, you may do so now. Mishe berachavoteinu mekor abracha leimoteinu, may the source of strength who bless the ones before us help us find the courage. make our lives a blessing, and let us say, Amen. Mishebera imotenu mekor avracha le'avotenu. Bless those in need of healing with refuah shelema.
Service continues at the bottom of page 252, but before we go there and before we proceed with the Hagbah, the ritual elevation of the Torah scroll, I want to take a moment and talk about this Torah scroll. It is one of the so-called memorial Torah scrolls. It is on permanent loan to Temple Emmanuel from the Memorial Scrolls Trust, which is in taking care of a little over 1,500 Torah scrolls that were collected. We're not entirely sure why. There's been some theories that have recently been, if not debunked, then at least it's been decided that they're not quite as convincing. But when the Nazis marched into Bohemia and Moravia, they have collected the Torah scrolls. So the Torah scrolls were collected at that time, carefully numbered and their provenance tracked. The communities, of course, were eventually destroyed. From some of them, no survivors left. From others, very few. This Torah scroll comes from the small town Harazdovice. Only seven people survived from Harazdovice that we know of. But a number of Torah scrolls from that town ended up in that collection. In 1966, these Torah scrolls were brought over to London, where a trust was set up to look after them. And then the ones that were usable, kosher, could easily be restored, have began to be given out on this permanent loan to Jewish communities throughout the world, very rightly believing that Torah scrolls, even the ones, or perhaps especially the ones that have come through that kind of an experience, don't belong in the museum. They belong in the Jewish communities that are going to use them as intended. Torah scrolls are not written to be displayed. They're written to be loved and read and studied. And so in 1967, this became the first Torah scroll that came to Temple Emmanuel, and it has been with us ever since. There was a brief period, perhaps not so brief, when the scroll was deemed beyond repair, and a lovely display cabinet was constructed for it in our lobby, where it resided from 2007 through 2020, I want to say, 2019. At which point a visiting scribe told us that it could actually be restored, and we've, as a community, engaged and raised funds, and many of us had a chance to actually write or help restore one of the letters. And so for, unfortunately our celebration was dampened by this pesky pandemic thing, but you know, we were not able to really come together as a community just when it came back, but it has been back in our ark, and all of our B'nai Mitzvah students once again get to read from this special scroll, not just celebrating the connection to thousands of years of Jewish history, not just reconnecting with our people, but also reclaiming part of a history, reconnecting with communities that perhaps are no more. But the Torah scroll is here, and we get to continue to hold it, read from it, and celebrate with it. And it's not easy, as Max will tell you, yeah. Right? It takes a lot of learning. But it is also a special privilege that we have as the Jewish people to continue, and as here at Temple Emmanuel, to continue to care for this beautiful scroll. And with that, page 252, would you please rise for the, and we call Steve for the Hagbah.
As well as Uncle Tony Lau and Linda Schaffner to redress the Torah.
Okay, Susan, should I move you?
Sorry.
Sorry.
That's okay.
Vezot HaTorah asher samoshe teran milifnei b'nei Yisrael al pi Adonai. Keep turning. Be'ad Moshe. One more turn. Okay. And keep it stretched. Keep it stretched. There we go. And bend the knees. And perfect. Textbook. Fantastic.
And we call Uncle Jerry Kampler to come up to hold the Torah.
Who's holding?
Uncle Jerry, keep holding.
He's coming? Okay. All right. If you come sit over here. There we go. You may be seated. Okay.
Before I start, can I get another second to breathe? My Haftarah comes from the book of Jeremiah, who lived in turbulent times of Jewish history. The Torah portion presents Israel with a choice between blessing and curses. Jeremiah assures us that after the people make a choice for God, they can be certain of divine favor. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher bachar b'nevi'im tovim v'ratza v'nevi'im ha'ne'emarim be'emet. Baruch ata Adonai ha'bocher b'torah u'moshe avdoho u'v'Yisrael amoho u'v'nevi'ei ha'emet v'tzedek.
We're on page 551.
Okay. Sure. You can use whatever works for you. Adonai, Uzi, Uma, Uzi, Uma, Nusi, Beyum, Sarah, Aleha, Gohim, Yavu, Uma, of Say, Aretz, Beyum, Meru, Ashaker, Nahulu, Avotenu, Hevelva, and Bamohil. Hayaselaho Adaham Elohim Bahamalaho Elohim Lachan Hinani Mariaham Bapaham Hazot Oriaham Etyadi Vet Gavurati Veaduhu Kishame Adonai Hat Yehuda Ketuvah Behet Barzel Betsipur and Shami here Harusha Aluah Libaho Ulkarnaho Mizbechotam Kis Korbenehem Mizbechotam Vashrehem all etranahan all Hageva Ot Hageva Ot Hamari Basadehe Lacha Kotse Oteka Lavats etehen Bamoteka Bachat Kahat Bechol Gevulecha Vashamata Ta Uvecha Minhalecha Asher Natati Hilach Vaha Avateka et Oiveka Baretz Asher Lo Yanataha Ki Esh Kedachtam Bafihi Adolam Tukahan Kaho Amahar Adonai Aror Hagever Asher Yivtahach Baadam Basaham Basar Tseroho Umin Adonai Yasor Libaho Bahaya Karahar Ba'arava Balaho Ire Ki Yavaho Toho Vashahan Hararim Bamin Bahar Aretz Ma'alacha Velo Teshev Baruch Hagever Asher Yivtaha Ba'adonai Vahaya Adonai Mivtacho Adonai Ki Ehet Shatu Almayim
Vehaya
Ke Ehet Shatu Almayim Ve'al Yuvahal Yeshalach Sharashav Ve'loho Yireh Ki Yavaho Chom Vahaya Aluahranahan Uvishnahat Patsorat Laho Yidag Veloho Yamihishma Mashot Parihi Akov Kalahev Moher Vanuhushu Midainu Ani Adonai Hoher Lev Mohen Kalaya Ahod Velatet Vela Ihish Kirahav Pari Kifre Maala Alahav Kore Dagar Velo Yalahad Oseh Osher Velo Vamish Pahat Bahati Yamav Yats Venu Uvecharto Ye Navaho Kisehe Kavod Maraho Marasho Mikoho Mikdashnu Mikvaya Israel Adonai Ki Otsvenu Otsaveha Kol Otsaveha Yovel Vasare Paaretz Yikatuhu Tehu Ki Atsevuhu Mohor Maim Hamaim et Adonai Rafanihi Adonai Va'arafihi Oshieni La'ushaha Ki Tehiati Ata Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Ha'olam Tzor Kol Ha'olamihim Tzadik Bechol Ha'derohod Ha'el Ha'ne'emahan Ha'omer Ve'oseh Ha'medaber Imechayeh Shekol Devarah Temet Vatzedek Al HaTorah Ve'al HaVodah Ve'al HaVenevi Ve'al Yom HaShabbat Hazeh Shenatata Lanu Adonai Eloheinu Litushav Ve'vnuchah Lech HaVahod U'latifaretz Al HaKol Adonai Eloheinu Enachnu modim laha chumarhim otah hatbarach shimcha befi kol hay tamid leolam va'ed baruch ata Adonai
uvaruch shemo
mikadesh ha-shabbat
Amen. Now you get to breathe out. Okay. Well, you still have a little more to just a little more.
A bar mitzvah is a ceremony in Judaism in which a child accepts responsibility for God's commandments. To be precise, bar mitzvah means son of commandments. It shows the child is now mature in the eyes of the Jewish people. My bar mitzvah means a lot to my family, including the ones who aren't with us anymore, as my family are direct descendants of Holocaust survivors, showing that even when my family/people's history and values were in intense danger, we not only survived, but we prevailed. Carrying on not only the history of my family, but the history of the Jewish people alongside us. But also, my mother's side of the family were Christians and Baptists, and fully supported me as I took on Jewish beliefs, saying exactly, they are proud I maintain a relationship with God. So having a bar mitzvah is a great way to spit in the face of the Nazis and the handfuls of others who hated us, and it shows how I carry on not only the legacy of the Jews, but the legacy of my family and God's eternal legacy too. My bar mitzvah's project plan is to help the homeless people, as my Torah portion directly mentions the issue of poverty and the rules to avoid permanent impoverishment for said person. I hope to direct my support to the Homes for the Brave Veterans Organization in Bridgeport, Connecticut. They provide care and aid to all the homeless but prioritize veterans, providing them a safe and friendly place to not only seek shelter, but to seek rehabilitation. Before we all leave...
You know, they don't get to leave just yet.
Oh, my bad. Scratch that. I'd like to thank a few people
yes!
who have helped me reach this milestone in my life. Let me start with an obvious thank you to my parents, who have not only funded everything, but have also raised me to be capable of something as difficult as this. I would also like to apply thanks to my grandparents on my father's side who have passed Judaism to me, and to the grandparents on my mother's side who have supported me being a Jew, even though they were not themselves. I would like to thank my siblings for giving me their tips and tricks for dealing with my parents long enough to make it to my bar mitzvah. I also believe my friends in temple, such as Dylan, who have made, wait, I lost my place, deserve a thanks as well, as they helped making learning enjoyable and made me look forward to coming on Wednesdays. I'd also like to dedicate thanks to my teachers and TE as well, such as Mora Janet, Mora Susan, Mora Oga, Rabbi, Mora Emily, and any other Madrachim and teachers that have assisted me, but especially Bela, as she was my tutor throughout most of this, and she played a major part in helping me learn what I actually know. Lastly, I appreciate anyone that showed up in person or distantly, such as sending cards or watching on YouTube. Finally, as tomorrow's Mother's Day, I'd like to thank my mother for not only raising me, but for being there in my life. Mom, I love you. And happy Mother's Day to the mothers, to all the mothers here and the future mothers with us.
Aww. Wow. Okay. Wait. That's it.
Translation.
That's it. Now you can breathe out.
Oh, finally.
But you don't get to go anywhere.
Wait, can I say one more thing? I heard some people over there screaming, like some of my friends getting mad they weren't there. Yeah. Yeah, thank you too. But thank you, Jake. And Sebastian and Jacob.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. First of all, for everybody who's gathered here, there are people in this room who grew up and had this kind of an experience, so they are reliving the glory or maybe a little bit of PTSD of all the learning that they had to do when they were preteens, that there are those for whom this is a first experience of such a ceremony. So first, a word of what you've just witnessed and what Max had to do. Hebrew is an ancient language, and it is written right to left. It is, as many ancient languages, consists of just the consonants. Well, it's not entirely true, but most of the letters in Hebrew, in the ancient Hebrew, are consonants. At some point, around the 7th century CE, the group of Jews known as Masoretes said, well, we need to make sure that everyone, no matter how well they know the text, can pick it up, pick up the parchment or a manuscript of the time, eventually print out. You've all picked up a chumash, open it and be able to read it correctly. Because when you only look in at consonants, right, it can go a number of ways. So they invented the system of vowels that are known as nekudot, and they are a collection of dots, and some dots are below the letter, some are above, some are to the side, helping us know exactly how to read each and every one word in the Torah. So far, so good. And then they said, well, what if your audience, when you read the Torah, doesn't actually know Hebrew? How do you convey the emotion and the importance of what's happening? And so they came up with this set of musical notes. They are pre-musical notes, but they're ancient musical notes known as Tamei Mikra, the cantillation signs. And so if you look at those cantillation signs, the melodies that developed in different parts of the world, because the Jewish community, of course, already at that point was living in different parts of the world and continues to be dispersed all around the world, in different countries, in different lands, Jews speak in different languages, develop very different musical melodies to go with this. And indeed, there are dozens and dozens of different melodies, depending on whether you were living in Poland or in North Africa, the melodies and the chanting may sound very, very different. But the notes are exactly the same. So far, are you with me? Consonants, then the added vowels, then the added cantillation notes. And so if you are going to try and figure out how to read from this Torah scroll, you need to learn to read Hebrew with the letters and the vowels, and then if you're going to chant from it, you have to learn the cantillation tropes. Am I correct so far? Am I explaining
that?
Okay, good. Just checking.
Hope so.
And Max have conquered all of that. The tricky part comes, if you thought that was tricky, no. The tricky part comes when you say, but the Torah scroll has been written on the parchment in a particular manner, over 2,000 years. Perhaps longer, but the earliest Torah scrolls that we have, the so-called Dead Sea Scrolls, right? In the middle of the 20th century, an entire library was discovered where scrolls have been preserved. And there are Torah scrolls as well as the scrolls of the prophets, which are written in contain exactly what we know today in 2023 and what we've known for centuries, which is a very powerful experience. You can see them in museums when you know that the Torah scroll has looked pretty much this way for over 2,000 years. So that means that we've been writing Torah this way long before the Masoretes came up with vowels. And since this is a document that we hold so dear, you're not going to start changing it and amending it. So while preparing for it, you can use the book or a printout, which I have prepared for Max, and he recognized these pages very well. So we use all of these aids, but then on the day, when you're reading from the Torah scroll, it does not have those vowels, it does not have those singing notes, it just has the consonants. And so in addition to learning how to do this, you also have to prepare and memorize, which is why it takes a good year of just practicing this. Eventually, by the way, it takes a lot less.
Yeah.
It doesn't have to take the whole. So next time you're chanting from Torah, we'll give you a couple of months for the first time,
yeah.
Right? But
yeah.
Bailey, you ready for the next stretch? Okay, good. Because I think Max is. And so today we get to acknowledge the commitment, and I want everybody here to understand just how much work went into, I know it looked, he made it look easy, right? And it sounded so authentic, but so much work. And you may have heard Susan and I, you know, not incorrect, but like help him in one or two places. Trust me, you need this. This is actually an agreement. That's not because he's doing something wrong. That's because this is a challenge. And it's also an honor, because you don't do this just because you're dying to do this. In fact, I suspect that Max was not dying to do this.
I'm dying while doing this.
see, this guy, he's good. But I think it's also important to acknowledge, Max, that the reason you are standing on this bima, it's not because somebody wanted you to stand on this bima. It's because you wanted to stand on this bima, and you wanted to do this. Your father and I had multiple conversations about disagreements where for some reason he decided that this is going to be one place where he's not going to push.
What a relief.
But I also want to acknowledge the fact that when your parents knew that you wanted to do this, they did everything that they needed to support you and help you get to places most of the time.
Yeah.
Okay. Did you see the little, okay.
Yeah,
and so once again, you are here not because somebody said, but Max, you must do this. You are here because you said, but I want to do this.
Yeah.
You are here because it matters to you at your young age what kind of a family you come from. It matters to you what our people and your people had to do in order for you to have a chance to do this on a day like today. And that is an extremely powerful thing to know and to act upon when you're just 13 years old, right?
Yeah.
Everything else, all the technical learning, and did you hit all the right vowel and all the right chanting, and you did most of the time.
Yeah.
Okay. But that's important. This is how we show our love and our devotion and our attention to detail. But what really matters is the fact that you are choosing to be part of a tradition that stretches back thousands of years and does some very unusual things in the process and keeps the Torah scrolls exactly the way they are and engaging with that and learning and teaching and taking 13-year-olds and saying, hey, let's take a person at the time when their voice breaks, when they are growing up, and let's do, what would they love most? Let's put them in front of a lot of people and make them sing. Right? That sounds like a good plan.
But it is also a wonderful opportunity for all of us to experience this moment when you step up and you say, I am now part of this. I'm part of my people, even when sometimes it could be a little difficult. Oh. So congratulations on doing this. I present you with your bar mitzvah certificate that says that David ben Shmuel Zev, you carry an important name, was called to the Torah as a bar mitzvah, and today's date and the name of the portion, and it says that in becoming a bar mitzvah, Max has accepted the privileges and responsibilities of being a Jew. Lifelong Torah study and the keeping of mitzvot, Shabbat, holy day and life cycle observances, participation in the life of the synagogue and the Jewish community in Israel, dedication to Tikkun Olam and the perfection of the world. So it's signed by me, signed by Susan, as a representative of the community, but there are two empty slots there. One is for you and one is for your parents. Because, of course, that kind of a commitment, it cannot be one way, right? It really has to be something that you also step up. And in your case, I'm so impressed with the commitment that you've already shown. In addition, I have a certificate for you for the future travel when you're about 16. You can travel with our movement, with Nifty, to Israel. And it's a gift certificate, actually pretty powerful this year. A change has been made with the help of the initiative called Route One and the Union of Reform Judaism combined effort. You're getting a certificate for $3,250 towards your organized trip with your peers to Israel when you're 16, which very much we hope that you'll get to visit the Friendship Garden at Kilat Shir Hadash in Surah Hadassah, and so on and so forth. So I'm putting these two things in here, but most importantly, right now, in recognition of you taking on these commitments, we're going to place the Torah into your hands. I'm going to invite all of you.
Before we do that, while I was reading my thank yous, I realized I forgot some people, such as my cousins.
Okay.
Can I just say that real quick?
Yeah, you can.
I didn't put them in as separately because I always categorize you guys as siblings. You guys have always been for me like siblings, and also anyone else who has made it, my dad's friends, my friends, family, everyone. I just want to thank you all.
You know, this is not the end of the service just yet.
Oh, well done.
You're good. Okay, so page 256, would you please rise as I place this Torah into Max's hands. Yeah, hallelujah, Shem Adonai, Kinizkav, Shemolevado.
We call up Sandra Schwartz to come on the
CR. Keren Leamo, Tehila Lecho, Hasida, Livne Israel. Am kerovo, hallelujah, hallelujah. Al shlosha devarim, al shlosha devarim, al shlosha, shlosha devarim. Ha'olam, ha'olam omed al shlosha devarim, al shlosha, shlosha devarim, ha'olam, ha'olam omed. Ribono shel olam, ruler of the universe, we thank you for the countless blessings that you have bestowed upon our people, children of Israel. We thank you for establishing your covenant with our ancestors, with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, with Sarah, Rebecca, Rachel, and Leah. We thank you for remembering that covenant and for bringing us out of Egypt, out of the house of slavery, to freedom. Above all, we thank you for bringing us to the foot of Mount Sinai, where Moses received this Torah from your hands, brought it to the Jewish people. We thank you today for countless generations of parents and children, of teachers and students who have cherished this Torah and passed it on from one generation to the next until we arrived this morning and placed this Torah into Max's hands. as he celebrates becoming a bar mitzvah, the son of the commandments that you issued forth in ancient times. On this special day in Max's life, we ask for your blessing on Max. We ask that he is successful in everything that he turns his gaze towards or lays his hands upon, that he's surrounded by love of his family and friends. And we do so by saying the words the ancient priests have uttered in your temple in Jerusalem. Yivarechecha Adonai v'yishmerecha, may God bless you and keep you. Ya'ar Adonai panav elecha v'chuneka, may God's countenance shine upon you and be gracious to you. Sa Adonai panav elecha v'yasem lecha shalom, may the blessings of God surround you. May God give you, Max, his gift of peace. And let us say,
Amen.
Ki lekach tov natati lachem torati al ta'azovu. Etz chayim hi lama chazikem ba v'tom cheha me'ushar deracheha darcheno v'chol netivoteha shah Ashiveinu Adonai Elecha v'nashuva Chadesh, Chadesh Yameinu Chadesh Yameinu Kekedem. All right, now you may be seated. Not you. Over here. And at this point, I'm delighted to invite Max's parents, Steve and Stephanie, to come up. So, come over here.
Yes, that's a good idea.
Okay.
Okay. First, I would love to thank Rabbi Farman for your patience and welcoming and everybody else that embraced Max and taught him everything he needed to know to be prepared for today. And thank you for putting up with Steve. I'm going to keep...
Thank everyone.
I'll keep this short and sweet like my husband. You said I couldn't roast Max, but you didn't say Steve. Okay. Max was born an old soul. He was naturally kind, compassionate, witty, and respectful of elders and anybody in the military. At two, he would often approach strangers, thanking them, as he would say at the time, for protecting me. That eventually evolved to thank you for your service. To see some men who didn't look well, some homeless, some missing limbs, and to see my little boy without being prompted to do so, to thank them. And it was just so natural and easy for him to do. And he just had a way to make somebody who looked like they didn't want to live one more day to smile and say thank you. When he was nine, on his own, he met with a friend, Jake. They met a young homeless boy, probably about 19 or 20, and they were concerned. They could tell by looking at him, he was needy, and we were in Wendy's at the time. Well, both boys demanded that we buy him something to eat. Well, once we were speaking to him, Max and his friend both decided we want to give him money, not money from their moms, not money from their parents, but their own money. Max often thought of that boy. He explained to the boys that how, you know, he ended in that situation, encouraged them to do well in school and obey their parents. Max often thought of him. Years later, we had a Boy Scout event and had extra snacks and candy. And without thinking twice about it, Max said, Mom, can we go to the shelter to bring it? Which we did. Another time, Easter, Max was concerned that there would be little children, even though Easter was a huge holiday in our home, that would not get an Easter basket. So we brought tons of candy there, and socks for veterans. This was something he did naturally on his own from a very young age. When he was four, my mom passed away. As devastating and hard as it is to lose your mom, no matter what age you are, I try not to cry in front of him, but I also believe in God and I believe in heaven, and I said, Grandma's in a better place. If anybody and everyone that knows Max knows how much he loves to play his video games, Max, without being told by his dad, would know that I was having a hard day and just pause it to come give me a hug to reassure me that they're in a better place. He didn't lose that compassion. When he was nine, my sister passed away. And Max continued to just stop what he was doing, whether he was on a phone call, playing a video game, about to level up to the next level, would just stop and give me a hug and reassure me that they're in such a better place. I do regret that Grandma Bev and Auntie is not here to see you and Uncle Pete, but I know how proud they would be, just as your dad and I are. Max, may you always be as kind and compassionate and witty as you are today. You are an amazing son, an amazing brother, and you will be soon an amazing uncle. We love you so much.
Thank you.
Ditto. Now, half of that is not on here, by the way.
It wasn't. I could add this.
Max, you got my sarcasm at the age of three when you said to me, you're kidding, right? you swiped the TV at four to change the channel?
Two.
Was it two?
It was two.
Jeez. In Walmart, he's up at a big TV trying to change the channel by swiping it. You've always been a mediator among your friends, interested in military history, computers, languages, and did I mention computers?
Yes.
Max realizes that his bar mitzvah is a step toward adulthood and not a pass to the front of the line. That while he has opinions and decisions and they hold more weight now that you're bar mitzvah, so do the consequences of those decisions, and that's part of being an adult. I know that the caring young man that I watched growing up way too fast is becoming the man he is starting to be today, and I love you for that. Thank you, and thank you all for coming.
Thank you.
Now you really get to sit down for a second. Thank you for those beautiful words. We continue our service on page 258. As I invite Melissa Porcal to lead us in the prayer for our congregation. A member of our board, our treasurer, our past president, in Max. Regalia.
Yes, this is Max's day.
Okay.
Congratulations, Max. So on the top of 258, source of all being, may the children of this community learn these passions from us, love of Torah, devotion in prayer, and support of the needy. May we guide with integrity, and may our leadership be in your service. May those who teach and nourish us be blessed with satisfaction, and may we appreciate their time and their devotion. Bless us with the fruits of wisdom and understanding, and may our efforts bring fulfillment and joy. Baruch ata Adonai, shehotecha levadecha b'yira na'avod.
Now, Grandpa David Thompson will lead us in the prayer for our country. Once again, page 258. So
this might be a little easier. It's a
okay.
It's slightly larger print.
Gotcha.
Just this one.
Starting here, my friend.
Yeah.
Okay. Of life and liberty, may our nation always merit your protection. Teach us to give thanks for what we have by sharing it with those who are in need. Keep our eyes open to the wonders of creation and then to the care of the earth. May we never be lazy in the work of peace. May we honor those who have died in defense of our ideals. Grant our leaders wisdom and forbearance. May they govern with justice and compassion. Help us also appreciate one another, to resist the many ways that we may serve you. May our home be safe from affliction and strife, and our community be sound, body and spirit. Amen.
Yeah, thank you. And now for the prayer for the State of Israel, Christina Kampler. Page 259. Well, you can use this. It doesn't matter. It's just a slightly larger print. Right, yeah.
You can sing. O Heavenly One, Protector and Redeemer of Israel, bless the State of Israel, which marks the dawning of hope for all who seek peace. Shield it beneath the wings of your love. Spread it over the canopy of your peace. Send your light and truth to all who lead and advise, guiding them with your good counsel. Establish peace in the land and fullness of joy for all who dwell there. Amen.
Amen. Right. We turn now to page 283. Would you please rise for Aleinu? Aleinu l'shabech l'adon hakol. Latet gedula liotzer breshit, sheusam chelkeinu leachedet shemo, vegohor aleinu leamlich malchuto, vaanachnu korim umishtachavim umodim, lifnei melech malchei hamlachim, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, 287. V'ne'emar v'haya Adonai le'melech al kol ha'aretz. Bayom ahu, bayom ahu yeh Adonai echad. Ushemo, Ushemo, Echad. As we turn around and we face the congregation, we conclude the words, we conclude our service with the words of Kaddish. And this morning, we especially think of those who, although not here in person, are very much here in spirit on this day as we celebrate with Max. Max's grandmother, Beverly Thompson, and auntie Marianne Martonic, and her husband, Peter Martonic, and great-grandparents, Mike and Frieda Lou Riley, and uncles, Dennis Thompson and Kenny Dyer, as well as Stephen's parents, who were Holocaust survivors, David and Esther Kampler, his uncles Max and Joseph Kampler, and his cousin Mark Kampler, as well as his aunts Pepe, Janet, Gossel, Margot, Sarah, and Henya, all of whom were also survivors. Max's cousins Peter and Paige Martonic. Oh, sorry, no, that's the next one. I'm sorry about that. Zecher tzadik levracha, may the memory of righteous endure for a blessing, may comfort come to all the mourners as we say the words of Kaddish together. Itgadal veitkadash me'rabah, be'alma divrach riuteh ve'yamlich malchuteh.
B'chai chon v'yomei chon v'chai dechol beit Yisrael. V'agalau v'zman karev v'imru amen. Yehei shmei rabba mevarach l'alam ul'almei almaya. Yitbarach v'yishtabach v'yitpa'ar v'yitromam v'yitnaseh. Veit hadar, veit ale, veit halal, shmedikut shabrihu, le'ela min kol birchata v'shirata, tushbechata v'nechemata, da'amiram v'alma v'imru, amen. Yehesh lamar abba min shmaya, v'chaim aleinu v'al kol Yisrael v'imru, amen. Ose shalom b'imromav. Uyase shalom aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael v'imru amen. May the one who creates harmony on high bring peace to us and to all Israel, and let us say amen. We turn now to page 321. Please be seated.
Don Olam Asher Malach Eterem Kol Yetzir Nivra Et Nasa Vehevto Kol Azay Melech Shemo Nikra Veacharei Kikvod HaKol
I'm going to invite your parents to come back up here once again for this moment. I'm going to invite all of you to rise.
Veshamru v'nei Yisrael et ha-shabbat, la'asot et ha-shabbat, ledorotam berit olam, b'ini u'vein b'nei Yisrael od hi le'olam. Ki sheshet yamim asa Adonai et ha-shamayim v'et ha-aretz, u'vayom ha-shvihi shabbat v'inafash. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam borei peri hagafen.
There we go. And Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam amotzi lechem min haaretz. So you can stand, or you can share some of the Kiddush with your parents. There we go. You can stand next to him, maybe even wrap your arms around him as we close this service and we celebrate this special moment in Max's life.
Okay,
yeah, absolutely, absolutely. There we go. As we say, Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech HaOlam Shechiyanu V'Kiyimanu V'Higiyanu Lazman Hazeh. Blessed are you, Adonai, our God, ruler of the universe, who have taken us on these journeys and kept us alive and brought us to the next generation of Kampler family, accepting the Torah into his hands. So Max, you carry a weight of your family and your family's history. And as we say amen, we celebrate this wonderful moment together. Now, I understand, let's make sure there's nothing left in there. Because I understand that Your parents think it's a good idea to let people throw things at you today.
Oh, yeah. Who has the candy?
All right, they'll figure out a way to throw the candy at you later. Okay, there we go. Later on. So at this point, then, we are going to... One more thing I wanted to point out. Over there, you will see, in seventh grade, our students work with our artist in residence, with Ann Eisner, to create, think about their life in terms of like the trees, you know, with the circles. Each year represents a circle. This is Max's visual midrash on his 13 years so far. And with that, I'm going to shut off the microphones and turn the guitar away. So if you guys want to pelt him with candy, you may do so. You may do so now. All right, ready, set, go. Simon Tov, Mazel Tov, Mazel Tov, Simon Tov, Mazel Tov, Mazel Tov, Simon Tov, Simon Tov, Mazel Tov, Mazel Tov, Simon Tov, Yehelanu, 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 Ulechol Israel, Yehelanu, Yehelanu, Ulechol Israel. So Max is going to bring out the challah into our Kiddush hall, and you can join him there. Give him a hug, have some challah, mazel tov, Shabbat shalom, and thank you all for being here.